sure that you are that love of mine. 'Cause I'm in a field of dandelions, wishing on everyone that you would be mine. Hi everyone, and welcome back. So today I'm going to be showing you how to make a pleated skirt, and they're really easy to make and fun to make. They're also really trendy right now, so yeah, let's get started. So as you can see, I'll be using the advanced template, and I've been recently using this a lot more because of how useful and convenient it is. And especially for pleated skirts, when I made my first one, it was really useful to make just because I could see where all of the other parts of the skirt are without having to like move it down to this bottom part here. It's kind of complicated. So yeah, even if you're a beginner, I recommend using this first, and then I'll be showing you how to transfer that onto the basic template here. Credits to blessedjenna for this template, and then also to slats for this advanced template. I added my own personal backgrounds and everything like that. But yeah, I'll be linking both of these templates down below if you want to use them, if you don't have them already. So to start off, I'm going to be making a new layer by going to the plus sign and empty, and make sure it's above your background layer. And I'll be using the go to the shape tool, draw and bezier, and this is a tool where if you drag a line, you can just release the mouse and move it around to make a curve, and it's really useful when designing, so I highly recommend to get used to that. So yeah, I will also be making my skirt a darker purple color, so I've chosen my outline color and my fill color right here. And for your outline size, I'm just doing a size 2, but whatever works for you. So you can see this white faint line here, and this is to help you kind of start off where you're going to make your high-waisted short pants or skirt. So I'm going to be drawing a line across this, and I'm going to draw move the mouse down a little bit to make that waistline. Then I'm going to just copy and paste that by using the select tool, dragging a box over it, command C, command V, and placing that right underneath that same line. Then to merge the layers, I just hit command 6, and there we have it. Now I'm just going to be making that for this side right here, because on the advanced template you only need to make this main box and this one side, because we're going to be duplicating it and copy and pasting it to the basic template. So yeah, I am just going to be doing the same exact steps for this box right here. So now we're actually going to start with the pleat of the skirt. So we're actually going to be making a pleat right in the middle. So grab your bezier tool, and right next to that middle line, just drag a diagonal line like so, and make it overlap this white line a little bit like this, and release to make a small curve. And then just copy and paste this to the other side, and don't forget to flip horizontally. Then right at the bottom, go to your bezier tool and complete the shape. So there's our first pleat. It's actually kind of fat. I'll be redoing this, but after you're done with your first pleat, just merge all the layers and there you go. Okay, so now this is my finished one, and now I'm just going to be repeating the same steps for each of the sides. So I'm actually going to be doing the same thing, except once you've made your new line, like right here, I'm going to be making this line curved a little inwards. Because it is on the side and pleated skirts normally look like that, so yeah. And at the end here, I'm just going to be drawing over the line in the middle of this line, because then I can just use my select tool and delete any overlaps, like so. Cool, so now I'm going to be going in, and we're almost done with this half. And we're only doing half of this right now because we can just copy and paste it and flip it horizontally to the other side. So now I'm just going to be going in with my line tool, and I'm just going to be drawing a line right in between these two pleats. So like right before they curve, it's a little too far. Like right here, just draw a line in between them. Okay, so now we can just copy and paste this to the other side. And any overlaps that you can see here, like this for the waistline, just use your select tool and then just delete the overlap. Oops, wrong layer. So I really like how it looks so far, and I'm actually going to be pasting what I just copied again, and we're going to be moving this to this side. And I'm going to be deleting the excess pattern. We're almost done. All we have to do now is just shade and color inside the shirts. Before I forget, I'm going to be merging all of my outline layers by hitting Command 6. And there you go, all of the layers have been merged. And I'm going to be starting the shading slash coloring tutorial. So make a new layer and get your new color ready. I'm just going to switch the colors here. And I'm going to be using, oh, make sure it's underneath the outline layer. And use your paintbrush tool, choose a good sized brush to fill everything in. I'm going to be choosing 15. Actually, let's do 20. And just fill the entire skirt in. Okay, so now that I've completed that and I've like erased all the excess coloring, I'm going to start the shading process. So this is going to be this is like my favorite part of this whole thing. So make a new layer and kind of choose a different color, but make it like darker than your fill color, but lighter than your outline. So like right about here is good. But then I'm just going to be coloring inside of the pleats. So like just an outline around it, and do that for all of the pleats. I made a new layer and I'm going to be choosing like a light purple color like this one, and I'm going to be outlining the main pleats. And I'm going to be making the final part of my shading. And I'm going to be choosing this kind of pinkish color because I feel like a good contrast would be nice. And I'm going to be doing that on the inside as kind of like an ombre effect. So like right around the bottom here, I'm just going to be kind of drawing something like this. So now I'm finally done, so I'm just going to go to my layers and click filter and details and then blur, and then blur the image. And so as you can see, my shadow and my shading and everything has gotten a lot blurrier, and I'll do the same thing to my newest one. And then I just go in and click these three dots next to the layer and increase the transparency. And that actually gives it a couple like more realistic features as well. I'm just going to merge my shading layers. Now I'm just going to be moving the outline layer above the shadow layers to make it a little bit more cleaner. And boom, look how pretty it looks so far. Now I'm just going to be moving this to my basic template. So to transfer the skirt, I'm going to be merging all of the layers here, except for the background, of course. And I'm going to be using my select tool to drag a box across just what's inside of this box right here, not below or next to, but just that box itself. Then hit Command-C and then go to your templates and hit Command-V. To copy and paste. And as you can see here, there is some like excess stuff here, so I'm going to delete that. Now just move it so that it fits that first box and adjust it so that, and use free adjustments to move it around. So as you can see, it hits like right on that green line and not above, and so that means that it's a really good length for your avatar. Now just go to that and duplicate it, flip vertically, and drag it down like this. And then just align them together. And as you can see, I don't want this waist strap here, so I'll be using my free adjustments and moving it down a little bit more. And then merge the two layers and move that underneath the background layer. Like that. Now I'm going to be pasting again because I already had this copied, and I'm going to be moving it to this backside here. So to move the side, I'll again just copy and paste this box and solely what's just in the box. And then move it across. And I'm also going to be making it align with the other layers. Then I'm going to be duplicating the layer and moving it to the other side. Then duplicate that layer again and move it down here into these boxes. Then I'm going to duplicate this again and move it to the other side. And I'm going to be flipping this horizontally. I'm going to be flipping this one horizontally as well, just to make it all kind of work together. Finally, we're just going to be uploading the bottom parts. So copy and paste that and move it over to the basic template. And how you're going to do this is just kind of align it with this. Like, as you can see, I'm just aligning it together with that and then duplicating it to fill the entire bottom part. Okay, so now all we need to do is just merge all of these layers and drag it underneath the background layer. Okay, so the skirt is all done. Now all you need to do is just upload it to Roblox. So this is the final product. I really like how it looks. I feel like if I would make a change, it would just be to kind of choose a lighter outline color and maybe do like less pleats on one side. But other than that, I really like how it looks. Like, I feel like I got the shading down. Like, it looks really good. And the pleats align together, which is really nice to look at. And yeah, so I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoyed watching and I hope you learned something. Make sure to subscribe. And if you want to purchase this skirt, then go down to my description box and click the link I have for you. Give it a thumbs up. Comment something down below, and I will see you in my next video. Bye, everyone!